strongest, most efficient machines they can.
I ain't building my sphere. Like the cheese that wins some, it's brain rust.
Sasquatch is another name for which monster?
Fresh flavor to Cartoon Network with my new show called Barbie Says. Think gravity's a friend? Think you're gonna look like a fool? Well, think again. But see, that's why I'm here. To help you avoid getting the case of the dumb dumb. Hey! So don't miss me on Barbie Says this summer, plus all the other great shows. Starting with the other signers and Survive This. June 17th, 8 p.m. Part of the new CN Real at Cartoon Network. How we is. It's real.
Okay, that is our new summer lineup coming in on the 17th of June. So, tell me one thing you did not see in all those new shows. Saw no cartoons, no animation. What else is kind of unique about the shows you think are different from what you expect from Cartoon Network?
It's targeting little kids.
Who said that? Are the kids. There were no kids in there that were not teenagers, believe it or not. Anything else you noticed?
Reality.
It's all reality-based, for the most part. So, one of the things that branding is teaching us, that even though people perceive Cartoon Network and they hear that name and they associate it with certain attributes, what our marketing department is going through is what we call a rebranding. We're changing what people think of when they hear the word Cartoon Network, and we're breaking out of just cartoon. So again, branding is very important in what we do every day, but let's talk about what it means for us as interns in this process. So first and foremost, everyone's sitting down way too long. We need two volunteers to come help us with this piece of it. And you don't have to be a marketing or advertising major, but we need two volunteers who pay attention to pop culture, watch TV, read magazines, pay attention to advertising. I need two. Someone. Come on up. Come on up. Give them a hand for our volunteers. One over here, one over here. Say your name.
Shintori.
Hey, what school are you at?
University of
Michigan. What's your name?
Junior.
Okay, junior. Want to be a junior or want to be a senior? Congratulations.
Hi, Sabrina.
Hey, Sabrina. How are you? What school? University of Pittsburgh, your major. And you're going to be a senior or
I'm graduating.
Hey, it's good for you. First of all, you guys are very courageous for even stepping up. You guys don't even know what you're up here for. So for being brave, we're going to give you, first off, a pair of tickets to watch the Braves this summer.
So, first thing you guys are going to do is help us do a little exercise. One for you. One for you.
So we're going to go through a training exercise that shows us what branding is all about. So you think you got skills. Here's how it's going to work. Each of you are going to stand in front of your bell, and you're going to watch your appropriate video on the other side. It's probably best if you look that way. And then you look at us, it'll be essentially good. So you're going to watch the next graphic that comes up, and as soon as you can identify the product or brand, I want you to hit your buzzer. When you hit your buzzer, be able to tell us what the name of that product or brand is, and the first thing that comes to mind when you see it. Everybody clear? Ready? Finest quality, benchmark customer service. They didn't include it here, but passionate pursuit of perfection is with them. So good job. All right, next one. It is Chanel. What do you think of Chanel?
Coco Chanel.
Coco Chanel, what else? Here's what they want us to believe about Chanel. It's the ultimate house of luxury. Couture is a keyword. Fine jewelry. Very best fragrance, makeup, and skincare. That is Chanel. Do we think Chanel's brand and their perception is actually what their product is? Do we think they're a match? Everyone? Right on the next one. This one for you.
iPod.
It is. What do you think of in here or an iPod or Apple? Here's what they want us to know. They started the personal computer revolution. They're all about innovation, digital media revolution, iPod, iTunes, the iPhone. Those are all things that are important to the Apple brand. All right. How about this one? Right here. That is Mr. Phelps. What's the first thing you think about when you think about Michael Phelps? Olympic champion. So, interesting point. Olympic champion, but marijuana is not one of the things you think about. It's off the top of my mind. So how does Michael Phelps' reputation affect the Michael Phelps brand? Anyone, real quick. His current reputation. The general. How do you think that affects his personal brand, Michael Phelps? Hurt. Well, for him, where does he feel hurt most? Of course, he's proud of them. He's no longer just an athlete. He's trying to endorse products that make sense for him because that's his paycheck. So when there's a scandal associated with his brand and his reputation, that scandal is taking dollars out of his pocket. So as a marketer, as a brander, his problem wasn't that he was smoking weed. Problem that it's cosmo. It's friends, all we know. It's all about friends. All right, question. This one. A-Rod. You think of Madonna? That's no accident, believe it or not. Don't need to see the accidents in Hollywood. So does his reputation support his brand, you think? His current reputation? Got it. What else besides Madonna and baseball do you think of him?
Steroids.
My goodness. When you think about him as his product, so many products he's endorsing, they're bought by kids, by 12-year-olds, 11-year-olds. And so that 11-year-old is thinking, and that parent of that 11-year-old is thinking, do they want their kid looking up to someone who just has been cheating or confessed to being cheating in sport? All right, next one. Simply based on her brand name. She has mastered this art. And the fact that you don't see her on all these tabloids drinking and partying is definitely not by accident. Because she has $4 million to think about every time she leaves the house.
Yeah.
Doing it right. All right, next one.